on, Dad.
Yoo-hoo-hoo! Chaps!
Yo! That's a big one!
Honestly, the most insane fish, the most insane.
What's up, guys? I'm so excited to drop this video, man. It's been a while. I think it's been 2 weeks now. I've been so excited to drop it. You know, I started this channel with the hopes of dropping a video every week, like a weekly upload, and yeah, I soon realized that YouTube is hard, just as difficult as driving in the Eastern Cape is almost. Okay, guys, so basically this video is going to be dedicated to bluefish and to big bluefish. So yeah, this was such a crazy day. It was such an awesome day. I really had fun. Ended up catching a PB bluefish. I was like saying it's the best fish of my life and this and that. Guys, I get so excited when I catch good fish that I'm just, every fish is the best fish of my life, and every big bump is a huge fish. And like, guys, I can't explain to you how much I love fishing, and that's actually at the end of the day what it boils down to, is the love for fishing. And that's why I started this channel. Let me get to it. This video is dedicated to bluefish, or bronze bream. We call them bluefish in East London, in Port Alfred, where I'm fishing mostly these days because I'm working here. Everybody calls them JB. So yeah, JB or Jan Brain, it's not actually the right name for them. And bluefish, as many people like overseas in America and elsewhere, bluefish are actually known as shad, our elf or our shad. So yeah, the correct term for them would be bronze bream. They're quite slow growing fish. They reach maturity at 30 centimeters. So 30 centimeters, it takes them about 5.5 years to reach that length. So yeah, they are fairly slow growing. And then after that, they only gain a centimeter per year. So after 30 centimeters, then it's pretty slow. And these fish are found, the bronze bream, all over our coastline. They are prolific in the Eastern Cape. You can find them at almost any spot. I mean, I think I've caught bluefish everywhere I've ever fished. So yeah, they're pretty cool to catch, and they're really fun fish. Pound for pound, probably one of the stronger fish that you can catch on these waters. I mean, even the small guys, you'll see in Jody's video, when Jody brings one of the bluefish in. I mean, first we thought cracker, then he was like, no, cob, then yeah, next thing it's a little bluefish. So yeah, like that's quite crazy, because even the little guys give you such a good run for your money. And yeah, it's really exciting fishing for them, especially with light tackle. Light tackle fishing is the way to go when you're fishing for bronze bream. What to look for in the water. So you want working water. Working water is always a good idea, and you want to fish on reef. So you don't really want to be throwing onto beach, onto sand. You probably aren't going to find bluefish just on sandy bottoms, unless it's scattered reef. But you know, pure surf fishing, probably not a good idea to target bluefish. Another thing is, I know many guys that fish for bluefish with pilchard and stuff like that. I'm sure you can get them on pilchard. I never have. Many people have said they have, but guys, it's not the way to fish for bluefish. You're not going to be as successful using pilchards or sardines. Better baits are pink prawn, sand prawn, mud prawn, swimming prawn, ginger prawn. Prawns are good baits. Otherwise, sand mussels also good for them. Many guys also use chocker blob bait. So if you just cut a small piece of chocker and you mallet that thing, you hit that thing until it's really, really soft, like almost that you can't even grip it, put that on the hook. It's another nice way to catch bluefish. Some bigger ones also come out like that. Yeah, so in a nutshell, that's how you target bluefish. And yeah, bluefish are also, they are rudimentary hermaphrodites, which means they are born with both female and male gonad types, and basically they become either male or female at maturity. So that's also quite an interesting fact. Most fish are actually hermaphrodites, though, some form of hermaphrodite. I hope you guys enjoy this video. Blacker.
Here's our bait of choice for today. Some good old prawns. Just want to show you guys quickly the trace I'm using here. So basically this little swivel here attaches to the main line. And then you get this little gimmick here, which is like a running sinker, a free running sinker. So you'll end up attaching your sinker here to this side, and then yeah, your sinker will run. And then obviously from this swivel, you'll tie your hook. So this will be your hook snoot. So yeah, that's the trace for today.
That's the bait
over there, and basically this is the running sinker here. So that's the running sinker.
I could have not thrown better now.
I'm literally lying in the spot I want to lie. So
yeah,
really hoping for something good.
Oh, and dad. Oh no. Nah, shit. Missed. On for a second. And it pulled like a mother. Yeah! Look at that, boys. Guys, the fish are here. The fish are here. The fish are here, boys. Yeah. Not very well. Jeez, Chapter, as I threw in, Daddy just got slammed. But it's coming. It's coming. We'll see soon what it is. There's a coming. Bluefish, yes. How does a bluefish pull like that, man? Yes, you chaps. Take a look at that. Okay, bring it, bring it, bring it. There we go, boys. Nice, Jones. Guys, this thing, hold it up here, Jones. Guys, this thing took him flat. Took him absolutely flat, chaps. Yew! Well done, Jones.
Also getting a little bit of bluefish action my side, guys, but doesn't feel too big. Feels like quite a small guy.
On, Dad. Yoo-hoo-hoo! Chaps! You! Ah, it's a nice one. He's a nice one. You, chaps! This can't be a blue. You! It is so strong, chaps! Woo-hoo-hoo! Take a look at that, boys! Take a look at that! This is crazy! Jeez, chaps, take a look at that! You! Yo, chaps! Wow! This is a sizer, guys! Woohoo! This is a sizer. Ah, wanted to take me around that rock. Ah, no, no, no! No! No, no, no! Oh, no! Chaps, literally taking me around this rock, yeah? Oh, Bria, he's taking me around it. Oh, here's he coming. Good. Yeah, it could be a little one. Yeah, it's a big one. It's a big one. Yeah, now it's on. It's a bunty. It's a big one. Yeah, the blue. The blue. Yeah. Chaps! No way!
Oh, we need to get a measurement of this thing.
Chaps moment. No, guys. This is too much. Chaps.
This is the most insane catch of my life. Like, I'm shaking. What the hell?
We're gonna get a measurement from it now. Let's put on a flat surface to find out.
53 centimeters, 52 and a half. Guys, this is crazy. We've kept the fish in the water here so long, so we're gonna go release it quickly.
Ever we release your last fish in there. Then I can walk with you. You and I are holding a bit in this water.
Let's go! Woo! Okay guys, so I'm about to go throw in again. As you can hear, my voice is gone. Like, I scream so much, guys. I get so excited when I catch fish that, like, I just lost it, because that is a fish of the lifetime, and I'm so glad we managed to successfully release it, because it was taking a long time. I think I stopped the video, but we actually ended up spending about 20 minutes almost with the fish in the water. You can see that it's changed now, like it's a bit darker. It's really so crazy, guys, but yeah, hoping to hook something again. I don't want to be greedy, but I'd love to catch a cracker or something, or punsi, just to show you guys. But yeah guys, it's really insane. I really didn't expect to catch something like that, and I'm really so stoked that I got it all on camera. Snapped up, so I want to show you guys a quick knot that I use quickly on the rocks. It's called double uni. So you just end up putting wrapping the nylon side like that, usually 4 or 5 times, depending on how thick your mono is. And then with your braid side, you end up just making a loop like that. And then you also just thread your braid through. The braid side you can loop through around like 10 times. Because you can end up making a bit of a thicker knot that side, so just put it through. Then guys, I always wet this part here, so in the middle, so that your lines pull smoothly together and that they can pull tighter, and that's what it looks like. So yeah, that's a quick knot for the rocks, guys. So yeah, that's a quick knot for the rocks, guys, and yeah, it'll get you by some big fish. I actually used this knot on that big bluefish that you guys saw, and I pulled that thing pretty hard, so yeah, it's a good knot. I just want to show you another trace I use as well when it's very foul. So you've got your single swivel here. Using a power swivel is probably better, but I don't have any of those now, so I'm using the cheapies. It's like R6 a bag of these for 10. Then attached to this side is your hook, so the line opposite your main line. That's the little hook there with the floaty, and then on the other side where your main line is attached, I attach the sinker line as well. So that's what I do here. Guys, the hooks I'm using, this is actually a size 1 mustard bait holder. I like the red, but the previous hook I was using for the big bluefish was a size 1.0, so 1.0 red mustard hook. These are the bait holders.
barn dad. Yo, chap. Onto another blue. This time not as big though. Ooh. For some reason it's wanting to take me around this rock here. Yay. Ah, come on. Ah, you're joking. Chaps, I don't know what's up with this fish today. They really want a reefer. It's a small blue. Let's see him come out. Yeah. Chaps. It's a little guy. Yeah, but that's lunch, guys. That's lunch. Woo! Come on, Dad! Woo-hoo-hoo! Let's go! Oh, no. Okay. Here's the gun. Let's go. This is a little blue fish again, guys, but oh, they're so fun to catch, man. Oh, no, I see it coming. Not a blue fish. I saw it in the wave now. Looks like something different, but I can't really make out what it is. Small though. Small fish. Let's see what it is. Sure guys, it's a shad. It's a little shad. What the hell? What? Chips? It's a shad! On sand mussel, that's so crazy. How's it the size of one hook? Look at that. Snapping away. Let's go. But yeah, I guess the size one, and not even a one hook. Check the fish here. So we got the little shaddy there. And we got two blues there for lunch. Now somehow managed to get caught together. So guys, when that happens, please, even though it's a lot of work and stuff like that, fetch your braid, guys, off the rocks and stuff. Like, don't just leave your stuff on the rocks. Oftentimes you see braid like this all over rocks and stuff where you're fishing, and it's not safe, and it's also not good for the environment. So yeah, let's be environmentally conscious, guys. Lekker.
Okay guys, I just want to show you how I'm preparing this fish that I got yesterday. So this is the shad and the bluefish, the little bluefish I got. Yeah, so basically it's very simple. You fillet the fish, then I skin the fish, and after that I just throw some masala spices on. So what I'm using here is sister-in-law masala. It's quite a good one. Not too much on the hot side. It is one of the hotter masalas, but I like hot stuff, so for me this is not too bad. Over here I've got some butter on the melt, and you can see it's a light spread of butter. It's not too much, so it's fairly healthy.
Alright guys, so this is how I do my fish. I was just thinking one day, I was quite tired of the whole batter story, and I was thinking of a healthier way to make fish. I am actually a dietitian. I'm a registered dietitian in South Africa. So anyway, I thought, you know what, let me try get rid of all the batter and stuff like that in the deep frying. So yeah, basically I thought, let me just fillet the fish, skin it, throw a bit of masala on, some salt, pepper, and shallow fry it in butter. Make sure that the pieces are thin enough. So I mean, if you catch a big cob or something like that and you end up keeping it, don't fry too thick pieces, because then it's going to take too long to fry. It's going to burn. So just halve it if you catch a nice cob or something like that, because the point is to make it healthier. So the point is not to deep fry it, or to use too much oil or whatever. So yeah, what I've done here is 2 spoons of butter, and that's how I shallow fry my fish. I mean, it's probably 2 minutes aside and then it's done. Guys, what you don't want to do is overcook your fish. If you leave your fish cooking too long, it becomes a bit tough, a bit dry. Nobody likes that. You want a nice, soft, tender fish. And so yeah, the worst thing you can do is overcook fish. Even if it's a little bit underdone, if it's fresh, it's actually fine for the most part. So guys, that's how I do my fish. That's how I enjoy it. Nobody actually taught me this, or I didn't see this from anybody, learn it from anyone. Like I say, I just experimented the one day because I wanted to make fish a bit healthier, and this is what I came up with. So yeah, looking forward to it.
But yeah, guys, I hope you enjoy the video. Please leave a like and subscribe. Let me know in the comments down below what you found interesting or what you enjoyed about this video. And yeah, always good, so good to hear from you guys.